Do you expect John Tortorella to be back next season?
Well, like I said, David, I'm not sure if I'll be back next season. So I think what we should do is...
Are you serious, Mike? Are you serious when you say you're not sure you're going to be back next season?
Well, I think everyone's open for evaluation. I think we've had players that have, excuse me, severely underperformed. Our team has underperformed. I think that we're all open to evaluation, and we all deserve evaluation, and that's what's going to come. And, you know, having said that, I have a clear vision of where we had to go. I had one 6 years ago. I have one today that we have to execute on in order to compete for the Cup in the Western Conference. And that's what I intend to do. But I think that it would be fair to say that we will all be under scrutiny and evaluation come the end of this season, which is deserved.
Well, a lot has been made of the style of the play Tortorella is coaching and whether it fits the players on the team. Is there a disconnect between the coach's style and the players? Or is too much been made of that?
Well, when you have an entire team's level of performance drop off, there has to be reasons for it. And whether those reasons are attributable to one thing and one thing only is unlikely. I think it's a combination of things that have contributed to us not performing at a level that's expected. And I think those things need to be addressed systematically and completely and turned around so that we can build the style of play and the style of team that we want to have here. You know, John's an accomplished coach. 6 years ago, everyone thought Alain Vigneault couldn't change from a defensive-style coach to an offensive-style coach. If given the resources and if the players are committed to it, I think any coach can coach the team that he has. But, you know, having said that, our problems are far-reaching, and they will be addressed. And if people don't want to get on side with how I view this team and how it's supposed to play, then they won't be here, just like the last 6 years ago.
Mike, when do you plan to sit down with ownership and talk about your future and where this organization is going? When will that meeting take place?
Well, that's an ongoing process. I talk to them all the time, and you know, I think that we'll do what we always have done at the conclusion of the season. We'll sit there and go through a thorough review of each player, each person in the organization, what they've done, where they are at, where we're at as an organization, as a team. Where we are at financially. You know, last year we had no cap space because of a reduction in the cap coming out of a lockout. We now have cap space that has been one of our strengths in using it. So, you know, we'll go through a thorough evaluation of what occurred this year. We'll go through a thorough plan of where we see we have to go. And they'll make a decision about which route they choose.
Mike, is there a possibility that you bring in a general manager and that you just retain the presidency and then handle it that way?
That hasn't been discussed. You know, the job here in Vancouver, as you guys know, is it is beyond a full-time job in terms of the responsibilities you have and the pressure and the scrutiny that you have. I accept that. That's part of the job here. We have really good people that work for us, so you know that hasn't been a consideration to date. But like I said, we're going to do anything we can to win the Stanley Cup. And if that means sharing some roles, if that means reorganizing this place differently, that's what we're going to do. And I am not in this to hang around and I'm in it to win. We got in it to win 6 years ago. We came really close, but we didn't finish it off. And my sole purpose here is to win, and I'm prepared to do what it takes to do that.
Traditionally, the Canucks have been a cap-spending team with not necessarily a real rebuild, but a retool and a conscious effort to allow youth roster spots. Are the Canucks still going to be spending to the cap next year with the cap going up considerably?
We will try our hardest to spend the cap, provided it's the right players and the right ages and the right positions. There's not going to be a ton of free agents out there, but we've managed to do well in the first week of July in the past 4 or 5 years. This year we got a couple players that everyone discounted in Brad Richardson and Mike Santarelli, and they ended up being performing at the levels that we expected. So, you know, there will be opportunities. We'll have to see what's available when we get there, but we have the resources to spend the cap, and we intend to do so, provided that the right players are there.
You've got a couple of key RFAs, too, to sign this year, most notably, and I'm a big fan of this guy, and he's proven to be, a player to watch. Zach Kassian and Chris Tanev. Have mm-hmm. there been any initial negotiations yet?
Not yet, no. They're both restricted free agents, and we like both of them tremendously. I think Zach is just scratching the surface of what he can do, his vision, his size, his toughness. Having played 12, 13 minutes this year, he's had a pretty good season and is tracking in the right direction. Chris Tanev, the same thing. Chris is a very steady, reliable defenseman who we miss when he's injured. And we're confident we have lots of cap space to get those guys signed, and we're confident that we'll be able to do it.
We're talking with Mike Gillis, General Manager of the Vancouver Canucks, as always brought to you by CMW Insurance. Mike, let's talk about Ryan Kesler. When do you plan to sit down with him and talk about the future?
I'll do the same thing I do with every other player. We'll meet at the end of the season, and we'll talk about his goals and objectives and how he feels about things, and we'll move on from there.
In your letter to season ticket holders, you mentioned how you would do a webcast with fans and mm-hmm. answer their questions. Has that happened, and are you still planning on holding that webcast?
Yeah, that hasn't happened yet, but absolutely. And it hasn't happened because we've, been in this, we're still struggling and have been in a place to still make it into the playoffs. So we held off on that, but, depending on what happens over the course of this weekend, I plan on doing that next week.
Let's get on to goaltending. Your vision for where this organization is going in that direction.
Yeah, well, you get people in Toronto that just love to carve the Vancouver Canucks, and it's going to be unending, so we're used to it now. But, it's unfortunate for a young guy like Eddie Lack, because Eddie is a very special player. He's got great personality. He's got great size. And his emergence allowed us to think a little differently about where we were going. And I have great faith in him. I think Jacob Markstrom is another 24-year-old goalie who has all the attributes to be a top-flight goalie of the National Hockey League. So I feel strongly that we have two young guys that are in their prime. I hope our fans get behind them and support them. If we had given any run support this season, he would certainly be, in my mind, a nominee for the Calder. Probably wouldn't win it, but should be in consideration based on how he played. I mean, he's lost more one-goal games than any goalie in the league, and he's second in the league in shutouts with half the games played. So, I think this guy has a great opportunity. He wants to be a Canuck. And I would love to see people get behind him because he's a terrific young kid.
Yeah, he's a raw young goaltender. His 17th straight game, I mean, wow, what more can you expect of the guy? But will we see Markstrom start a game this season?
Yeah, we will. Rolly's goaltending coaching style is very specific, and he works really hard with these young guys. And, he's determined that they get in when they've shown him enough in terms of their fundamentals and practice to be ready to play. And Jacob is getting there. We got him from a different organization that approaches it differently than we do. And we have a lot of faith in this guy. Like he's a competitor. He's huge. He's athletic. And there's some things that he needs to work on to reach the next level, but he's spent his time in the American Hockey League. He's now spending his time in practice here with a lot of time with Rolly, and he's really moving in the right direction, so we will see him before the season ends.
Mike, one final thing for me, and that is this. If you were going to say one thing to the fans of this city right now, what would it be?
Well, I think, we've had a lot of success in the past, and none of this sits well with me. It's been an incredibly frustrating season on a variety of different levels. And for me, I'm committed to getting back to the levels that we expect. And we have a plan to do it. We had a plan 6 years ago to do it, and we got as close as we could get. Learned a lot of lessons from that. And, you know, I'm tired of chasing a moving target. We're going to get back to the fundamentals and the principles that I believe in, and that's how we're going to play. And like I said, if people don't want to comply, and we did this 6 years ago, we made hard choices. And those hard choices are going to come again if we don't see people that get on the same page.
Well, what do you want the team to get back on? Like, what is it? What is that vision?
I want us to play upbeat puck possession, move the puck quickly, force teams into mistakes, high transition game. And I think we have the personnel to do it. If we don't have the personnel to do it, they'll be changed.